his first Iditarod in 1979. Now he's running for the umpteenth time at the age of 69. He's broken more bones than Evel Knievel, and he's lost a toe or two. But he always finishes, he's never scratched. Yeah, his team always comes through. So if I'm late for dinner, don't holler at me, dear. I'm training to be a winner. Yeah, I'm out mushing dogs with Jim Lanier. He trains his all-white dog team in the woods of Chugiak. He's taught a lot of puppies to G.N. Hall down by the railroad tracks. You'll see him lend a helping hand when a youngster gets his start. His love for the sport is something that he sure likes to impart. So if I'm late for dinner, don't holler at me, dear. I'm training to be a winner. Yeah, I'm out mushing dogs with Jim Lanier. Lanier's made a million memories and relates many a tale, like the time a flock of chickens lured his team off of the trail. A dozen dogs stuck in a coop in a scene that was most wacky. A few hens wound up fricasseed, and Jim lost 2 hours to Mackie. So if I'm late for dinner, don't holler at me, dear. I'm training to be a winner. Yeah, I'm out mushing dogs with Jim Lanier. Of each Iditarod, Jim performs a special song. Perhaps next year he'll do this one and we all can sing along. So if I'm late for dinner, don't holler at me, dear. I'm training to be a winner. Yeah, I'm out mushing dogs with Jim Lanier. So if I'm late for dinner, don't holler at me, dear. I'm training to be a winner. Yeah, I'm out mushing dogs with Jim Lanier. Yeah, Jim says once we finish the Iditarod, we can turn around and do the Dora Titty. That's Iditarod spelled backwards. The idea is to start in Nome and race all the way back to Anchorage. Of course, he didn't tell me if that means the dogs have to run backwards. I'm not really clear on that. Anyway, baby, I'm out mushing dogs with Jim Lanier. I'll see you later on.